If you're a filmmaker, content creator, videographer, photographer, what have you, we all have the same problem, and that's storage. Every project means more footage, more files, and more headaches. You buy another external drive, and then another, and then another, and then another, and then another, and before you know it, your desk looks like a tangled mess of hard drives and cables. And don't even get me started on cloud storage. Yes, it's convenient, but it's slow to upload, to transfer files, and heaven forbid you forget to change that feature to allow anyone who has access to the link to actually open the file. If only there was some type of technology that could help solve these problems. Oh yeah, there is. This is the UGREEN NASync DXP4800 Plus, and it is a NAS system, aka a network attached storage device for all the nerds out there. And if you've never heard of a NAS before, don't worry, most of us haven't when we first started, and even when we do hear about it, we pretend like we know what it is, but we still really don't, not like right now. So don't worry, because today I'm going to break down what a NAS is, and why it's a game changer for any creator out there, and more specifically, why I think the UGREEN NASync DXP4800 Plus may be the best one to start out with. UGREEN is a sponsor of this video, and they did send me this NASync to try out, but rest assured, this review is my own honest opinion. All right, so let's run it back. So what exactly is a NAS? Think of it as your own private cloud, but faster and safer, and best of all, with no monthly fees. You have a physical device in your home or studio that stores all your stuff, and you can connect to it over Wi-Fi or a wired network, so you can access your files from anywhere on your laptop, phone, tablet, or even your TV. So for us creators, that means no more scrambling around our 50 plus hard drives that we own in our drawers, trying to remember what footage was on what drive because you didn't properly label them, even though you should have, but now so much time has passed that you just didn't do it. And it's having that security, that safety net, and not having to worry about if a drive fails, that all that amazing footage that you shot is now gone forever. One of the biggest advantages to having a NAS is the overall storage capacity that you can have. Now, the NASync DXP4800 Plus can support up to 112 terabytes of storage. And now going back to having your own personal cloud, the huge benefit to having your NAS and utilizing it in that way is the actual time it takes to upload your files. If you're uploading to a cloud service, that can take a really long time and will depend on your internet. Here, you're still backing up to a physical device, and the NASync gets up to 1250 megabytes a second of transfer speeds, which means you can transfer 1 terabyte of data in just 20 minutes. And now that you have your stuff stored onto your NASync, you know everything is safe, secure, and you can have that access no matter where you are, which is a big deal if you're traveling a lot, you're going to different studios, you have different locations, out of town. You know, as long as you have access to the internet, you're going to have access to your files. But enough of me explaining all this. Let me show you how to actually set this up and get it going. The overall design of the NASync is nice, although a bit bulky, especially if you're not used to having a NAS. Just know that you're going to need some extra space on your desk if that's where you plan to store it. On the front of the DXP4800 Plus, we have our 4 bays where we will install our hard drives. There's a power button, network and hard drive indicator lights, SD card slot, USB-C 3.2 Gen 2 port, and a USB-A 3.2 Gen 2 port. On the back, we have the magnetic dust mesh filter. We have a HDMI port, USB-A 3.2 Gen 1 port, 2 USB-A 2.0 ports, 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, and a 10 gigabit Ethernet port. All right, now let's install the hard drives. First, need to press the buckle to pop the handle out, and then we'll pull out the tray. And I'll be using these 3.5 inch Western Digital 4 terabyte hard drives that UGREEN had sent over with the NASync. And we're gonna flip the drive tray to the back. Then we're gonna press the buckle marked with the press icon to pull the arm out. Then we wanna place the drive on the tray and ensure the 4 fastening pins on the tray, there's 2 on each side, are aligned with the screw holes on the drive. And then once those are aligned, we're gonna push back the clamp arm to secure the drive. And I'm just gonna give it a slight shake here just to make sure the drive is secure. And now we're gonna do the same with the 3 other trays. And now that we got all our hard drives locked in, we're gonna load them back into each drive tray. And after we do that, we're gonna use the provided locking tool and then lock each bay so they don't accidentally open. Now the DXP4800 Plus does support installing M.2 SSDs as well. There's 2 slots on the bottom of the NASync. All you gotta do is unscrew the cover to reveal the slots. Now that we got all the drives loaded up, we're gonna plug in the power and the Ethernet cable. We're gonna place it on the desk, find a nice little spot, and then turn it on. Now that we have our drive set up in our NASync, we've got it plugged in, it's connected to our network. Let's go ahead and download the UGREEN NAS client. I'm gonna do it for Mac OS. Let's copy that over. Go ahead and open it up. New device registration. Perfect, it picked up mine. So I'm gonna hit register. I have read and accepted. Hit start. So now I'm gonna name my device. Hit next. Register and bind UGREEN cloud account to enable remote access. Cool, and now we see the welcome screen. Hello, welcome to UGREEN NAS. We'll hit start. They have some guides that'll walk you through the next steps. And we see here, these are all the features that Storage Manager offers. We have flexible storage layout, real-time hard drive health monitoring, convenient external storage management, and instant notification of errors. And what's great is you don't have to panic with this NAS because it's literally walking us through all the steps. So if you're worrying, seeing that word storage pool and like, I don't know what that means, I don't know how to set that up, they're literally walking us through it right now. As it says right here, first, let's start by creating your storage pool and volume to make data storage simple and enjoyable. So we hit create and we see all our hard drives here. And after I've selected all four of my drives, we scroll down here. We can see all of the different RAID options. And I'm just gonna be honest, this is a whole other video kind of breaking down all the different RAID systems and the pros and cons of each one. But for now, we're just going to walk through this. We see here that UGREEN has recommended RAID 5. So we'll go with that. We'll select RAID 5, hit next, and we'll go with what's already selected here. Hit next. And here's our preview here of our storage pool. Hit create. And as this tip pointed out, if you have any information on these drives, say you've already set this up before and you want to try and do it again with stuff already on it, this will wipe out all of the drives. All the information on there will be gone. So just keep that in mind. And then we're going to hit format. And it's now creating our RAID. Creation successful. Nice. That was pretty easy. Now that is good to go. It's optimizing our volume. All right, now everything is set up and ready to go. And what's cool is it has this interface. It's almost like a little mini computer, kind of laid out similar to a PC, especially with that wallpaper. And here are some apps that will help us manage our data and manage our RAID system. So obviously File Manager. These are where all our files are going to be. We have the personal folder, shared folder, and then user folder. Main difference here, personal folder, if you're going to be using this as a way to store, say, personal photos, videos of that nature, you can actually use this as your own personal media hub. If you want to put movies and stuff on here, you can plug it into your TV. It has that HDMI port in the back, so you'll be able to do that. The shared folder pretty much acts as your own personal Dropbox or Google Drive, which is really cool. And you can set permissions on who has access to what. And I have two folders here. I actually messed up. I put this editing archive because, again, I'm going to be using this as a way to back up and archive my past projects. But I created this folder here on its own. I actually wanted to create this main folder, Stone Harbor Entertainment, which is my video production company, and then create that folder in here. Now, say for this instance, like me, you created a folder you actually didn't mean to create and you want to delete it. Thankfully, it's actually not easy to just hit right click and hit delete. That's not even an option. You would have to go up here to management, shared folder management, select the folder that you want to delete and then hit delete over here. And then it'll confirm that you want to delete the folder, hit okay. And then you have to enter your account password before it actually deletes it. And this is a great fail safe, especially if you're working with shared files and other people have access to them. And they have their own app center. If you click on it, there's other apps you can download here. Music, Photos, Video Center. If you are someone looking to use this NAS more as a personal media hub, these apps will help you organize all that a lot easier. What's cool is the UGREEN NASync supports various RAW formats for mainstream cameras in the photo album. You can download Firefox on this thing, its own web browser. This can really be its own unit where you don't have to necessarily control it through a computer. But for me and how I'm going to be using it, I won't really need any of this stuff. Like, I don't need text editor or anything like that. I'm pretty much good with the file manager and how I'm going to be using shared folders. So now I'm going to drop some files in that shared folder and show you how you can access them on all your different devices. Now I have my Zeit drive right here and I do want to plug it into my UGREEN NASync here and see what that's like. There's a USB-C port here in the front, so I'm going to plug that in. We see a pop here. External storage device enclosure has been inserted. We'll go to File Manager, go to Peripheral, External Storage. Now, mind you, the NASync is not plugged up to my computer in any way. This is all through the network. And I have some files here. I'm just going to copy one file over. It's going to be a video file or short clip, actually, just so you guys can see what that looks like from an external drive plugged into the NASync. Now, this clip is a project I'm working on. It's all done in Unreal Engine. It's 3D animated, utilizing motion capture. So I'll double click here. Can I preview it? Nice. So this is showing our mocap that we captured with a couple GoPros and the final result up top. Nice. So now I can right click, select copy to. Let's do straight into that file. When the file already exists, skip overwrite, skip for the future. just in case. Okay, that's weird. I got a warning that it didn't work, but then up here it said it did work. So let's exit out. Let's see if it did. And it did. Let's double click. Nice. Now let's look at some of our other devices that we have connected to the NASync and see how we can view this same clip. All right, so first, gonna try it on my iPhone. I have the UGREEN NAS app installed on my phone, and we're going to log in with existing account, device address. Let's tap here, internal network device. I have my iPhone on the same network as my NASync, and it found it. And now we're in, similar layout. We got all the different apps here at the top. And I'm gonna go over here to file manager. Let's go over here to shared folder. And there's that clip, tap on it. And there it is, playing. Awesome, that was pretty easy. Got the file I created there earlier too. Now I have access. Don't need Dropbox, don't need Google Drive, don't need none of that. It's all right here and I'm in full control. Now I'm gonna show you what it looks like uploading more files from a different computer onto the NAS over the network. So the computer I'm on now is connected to Wi-Fi, and I'm going to upload a full project file that I have here. I'll choose my Final Cut Pro on the iPad Mini 7 video, and I'm gonna hit upload, and we can check here the status of that upload. Granted, this isn't going to transfer as fast as plugging a drive straight in, because this is now uploading over Wi-Fi. But in this situation, it's more archiving footage, so speed doesn't really matter. I can just leave this to upload overnight and forget about it. Now that those files have copied over from my other computer, I'm here on my iPad. Go to File Manager, Shared Folder, go to that Editing File, go all the way down the pipeline, and we can see here that Final Cut Pro on my iPad Mini 7 file is now there with all the files and the assets. And so I can go here to Shares, I can view the final edit. And what's cool, I'll show you too, you can actually choose how you want to stream the file. Down here it says original 4K, or you could switch it to 1080p to get a smoother stream. So I can go back here if I wanted to look at all the raw footage as well. I can play all that because all those files are now backed up on my NASync. There we go. And still streaming at 1080p. I could switch that to the original 4K if I wanted to later, but all that is there. And that's really awesome. I got all this backed up now to my NASync, because now I can access them from all of my devices, whether iPad, iPhone, from another computer. I checked the Apple TV. Apparently, that's just for the media app on there that we saw in the App Store if you wanted to watch movies or other type of video files. So I think they're going more for kind of just entertainment on the Apple TV app. So that was a little disappointing, but definitely understandable. And what's great is you have options on how you want to back up your data, right? You can back it up over the network, right? That's gonna take a little bit longer though. Or you can plug in straight your drive into the NASync, back up that way. Now let's talk about price. The UGREEN NASync DXP4800 Plus costs $699.99. But with World Backup Day coming up, you can get 20% off by using the links down in my description. Now that doesn't take into account the actual hard drives that you have to get in order for this to really work. But you can find 3.5 inch hard drives for around $100 to about $200 depending on the capacity that you want, which is also not including M.2 SSDs if you also want that. So this whole thing is definitely gonna put you over $1,000. So I can understand as a new creator why you might laugh at that and be cool with your SanDisk Extreme Pros. But if you're in a place where you feel like your hard drives are kind of starting to pile up, the organization of everything is just getting a little too chaotic, you might wanna start looking at getting one of these. There is a cheaper 2-bay option, or if you're looking at this and the 4 bays aren't enough, there's a 6-bay and an 8-bay option for you to look at as well. So before writing off this whole concept of a NAS, just really think about where you are right now and your workflow, right? I mean, think about all the things that we invest in, like we'll invest in the cameras, we'll invest in the lenses, all the accessories, but the most important thing is making sure our data is backed up and secured. If we don't have that done right, all that other stuff doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how good your image looks if all your files are gone. And trust me, I know what that feels like, unfortunately. So overall, I am loving the NASync DXP4800 Plus. I've only had it for a short period of time, but I already see the huge benefits that this is going to have with my setup and my workflow. The setup is easy to understand and the software is easy to understand, but the best part is not completely dumbed down either. This can be as simple or as advanced as you want it to be. And I think that's where the uniqueness comes in with what UGREEN has set up here. The fact that it could just be a simple entertainment system or an advanced archival backup system is actually pretty dope.
And with its overall size, like I had mentioned before, it is pretty bulky, but that is kind of what you're getting whenever you get a NAS system, especially with this. It's got four bays, so you kind of expect that. But for people who don't have experience with NAS systems, they also do get a little loud. So for those not used to it, it can be a little annoying, but this is pretty standard with these systems. But for the NASync specifically, it's not that bad in my opinion.
So personally, I would recommend looking into the DXP4800 Plus. If the price of the 4-bay is too intimidating, at least check out the 2-bay. I highly recommend it. Because when you think of how we invest our money in content creation, we buy the cameras, we buy the lenses, we buy all the crazy accessories, right? We buy the super dope, super powerful computer. But when it comes to a hard drive, hey, what's the cheapest one you got? No, that's where we have to rethink these. And I'm speaking on personal experience, right? Start taking this stuff seriously, because it doesn't matter how awesome and amazing your image looks. If you don't know how to properly store it, it's not gonna matter. And that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. If so, please like and subscribe to the channel to see more content like this. And until next time, keep your files safe and backed up, and I'll catch y'all later.